Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen. Now we are streaming some Pokemon Sun tonight, and I hope that you guys are excited because I'm happy to play Pokemon again, you know. Always happy to be playing Pokemon, but it's been a while. It's been a whole week, and you know, we left our team in a pretty solid state, mind you. I mean, we got Lucina the Umbreon in the last stream, and we also now have an Alolan Raichu named Butter. And yes, that is adorable, but last but not least, we now have Genus the Arcanine. And I am super excited about that. You know, we had 3 evolutions in the last stream, and that makes me very happy. Ugly Bob Gaming, thank you very much for subscribing on YouTube. I really do appreciate that you're enjoying the content so far. Enough anyway to hit subscribe on YouTube. Alright, so, continuing on with our journey, I think that actually would be appropriate if we went. I think that we need to stop by the Pokemon Center again. Let's go ahead and call our Charizard, our new service Charizard, I guess. And then we'll go to that little town that's very close by. What is it, this one? Koni City. Yeah. I'm pretty sure that that's the one. So yeah, we weren't too far down the trail, whatever this route was. We weren't too far down that route. So I just want to go ahead and quickly go back to the Pokemon Center because my Pokemon really need it. Oh man, but yeah, so many great things happened in the last stream. I still have to go ahead and actually evolve Kadabra into Alakazam, but I'm honestly just not feeling it right now. I think that what's his name, Andre, is okay being a Kadabra for just a few more streams. We'll get to that point when you'll become an Alakazam. Just patience, Iago. Patience, Iago. Do we have enough items right now? I feel like we don't really have many potions. We've got 4 super potions, but you know, that's kind of meh, you know? Yes, you do need to trade in order to evolve him, so that's what I'm saying. I don't feel like booting up whatever it is called, the Festival Plaza. Yeah, I don't feel like going into the Festival Plaza right now and running a trade. Yes, I know that it's, I guess, counterproductive, but you know, we'll just keep trucking along. I'm still pretty confident, you know, in our team. Sneaky Pancakes, what's going on? Welcome to the stream. How are you today? Oh man. Like I said, so stoked that our team saw 3 evolutions in the last stream. And you know, I'm excited to be playing around with Alolan Raichu, you know, our cute little butter. Man, Thunder and Psychic, that to me is a first. I'm pretty sure that there was no other Pokemon before Alolan Raichu that was both electric and psychic, right? Whoa, a Phantom. Did we run into this before? I feel like we didn't, so I don't know. I'm not entirely sure. Okay, let's just take this guy out. Come on, Lucina, you got this. My Fire Emblem friend. Man, poor Phantom or whatever it's called. Dude, the way that it sounded when it died, that just made me pity it. Did it really deserve to be treated that way? I believe not. I'm good, you. I named my Alolan Raichu Lilo. Nice. From Lilo and Stitch, I'm guessing. That's also a very adorable name. But thank you for asking. I'm also doing very well. Just, you know, always happy to be here on these streams and all of that with you guys here in the chat, of course. So, oh, Ghastly. But we already have a Ghastly. Going back to our little discussion of Gengar. You know, I love Gengar. I really do. But like what I said before, I think that what kept me from using Gengar was that either my brother or my friend, who I also played Pokemon with before, he had a Gengar already. So I was like, you know, I'll try to reduce the amount of Pokemon that we have in common as much as possible. So I ended up never using Gengar, even though he's a fantastic Pokemon. He is such a good Pokemon, Gengar, you know what I mean? And now let us take time to just pity this Ghastly. We gotta move on. We don't have time for these Ghastlies. Akala Outskirts. Okay, I feel like we're getting pretty close to the Grand Trial now. At least I'm really hoping that we were, because we were supposed to reach the Grand Trial in the last stream, but we spent so much time in the Diglett Tunnel that did not happen. Come on, Wingle. Don't try to stop me now. Ghost Pokemon are already dead. Then shall we take the time to pity the fact that they are already dead? I don't know. Ghost Pokemon are really interesting, you know, and of course it's mainly because of their Pokedex entries. Like, they're... you gotta admit that they are pretty creepy. I mean, think about... what was it? I think it was, Drifloon. Dude, like, I didn't mention it before, but Drifloon is a terrifying Pokemon. As adorable as he might be, as adorable as he might appear at first, his description says otherwise. Apparently, he takes away children. Like, he kidnaps children. Like, he's a balloon, and children love balloons. So naturally, what would a child do if he saw a balloon? He would grab hold of that string. And then before you know it, the child is being taken away to who knows where. Yeah, Drifloon is a child predator. I believe you. I mean, I agree with you, Ugly Bob Gaming. Truly, he is a child predator. Why's it gotta be this way, Pokemon? First Hypno and then Drifloon? Like, there's so many other creepy Pokedex entries, you know, but I'm not recalling many of them right now. A lot of them, yes, did have to do with those ghost-type Pokemon. Yeah, maybe I shouldn't use Drifloon because I don't want it to appear like I support its lifestyle, you know what I mean? I don't approve of your lifestyle, Drifloon. That's not what you should be doing to poor children. Hello, beautiful Melodic. Welcome to the stream. How are you doing tonight? I should say this afternoon. Yeah, it's not really evening yet. You wanna fight, don't you? You've got that look in your eyes, that fire that trainers have in your eyes. Dang, Lucina is behind in levels. I'm gonna throw you out there. You've got to do some leveling there, dude. Leech life has been buffed this gen. Really? Didn't even notice. Yo, what's going on, Sealskin? Welcome to the stream. How are you doing? Yeah, not all evolutions are good. And Umbreon is okay. Umbreon isn't the best, isn't my favorite even. Still, I'm happy that she at least got out of that first form, you know, and she's usable now. She's usable. Right, Lucina? I love you just the way you are. I'm going to resist the urge to start singing that very popular song due to content ID. Yeah, fun fact, guys, we're streaming this on YouTube at the same time. Isn't that just great? First time using Restream in such a long time. Still, my main platform will be Twitch. YouTube is... yeah, I'll do Restreams on YouTube too. I'll pay attention to both chats, but what I mean is that, you know, YouTube will be the place where I send my archives to and all of that. Man, and I said this before, but I really want a Starmie. Where can I catch a Staryu so that I can get a Starmie? Sylveon is the best? Oh, really? You like... oh, Sylveon. For some reason, I read that as Umbreon, and I was like, wow, that's a first. But yeah, Sylveon is also adorable. But I wasn't sure. I'm still not sure how to evolve Sylveon, or how to get Sylveon, I should say. It's probably going to be a bad idea to keep this little dude out with a giant Gyarados, with its giant attack stats and its giant ego. Come on, Butter, show him what you're made of. Show him what you got. Ha, you think that's going to do anything to me? Oh, actually, I'm pretty sure that this is... yeah, it's physical now. Okay, maybe this will do something to me. We could at least nuzzle him. I'd be satisfied with paralyzing him to start out. Still, even with our attack stat decrease, that still did a decent amount of damage. I'm surprised. Oh man, he's getting ready to come in for the kill. There is no usable- oh yeah, that's right! That's right! That's okay. We'll survive this nonetheless! this man probably just evolved his Magikarp into Gyarados Tomb, and he was so ready, so excited to have him on the battlefield for the very first time. And look what happened. What's with the face, Ugly Bob? Did I say something that did not please you? Man, all of these Zygarde creatures or whatever. Sina wants to talk to you. You've collected only 10%, really? I felt like we would have been at least at 20%. Oh well. If you'd like to know what this number means, please come to the Aether Base on Route 16. Okay, well, that's not our focus right now. Our focus, rather, is making our way to the Grand Trial. Like, are we even going to be able to make it to the Grand Trial in this stream? I really hope so. Oh, is it being checked by admins? You know what? Here's what I'm gonna do, okay? I'm gonna go on Twitch. I'm going to turn off the auto mod right now because I feel like Yo, Volve, what's going on, man? Welcome to the stream. Okay, yeah. Like I said, I'm gonna go ahead and go to the settings. Sorry that auto mod is being such a pain, Ugly Bob. Yeah, I was hoping that it would be a good way. You know, a good way to go ahead and stop those nasty trolls, but no, it looks like it's not really working in our favor. What's going on, Vol? How's your day been? I believe that security and privacy, the channel and videos? Automod, as nice as you are, I think that... Here we go. Okay. Everyone say goodbye to Automod. Goodbye, Automod. Now, Twitch would do this weird thing sometimes where I would change something in the settings and then it wouldn't actually save the settings. Yeah, see, it's doing it again. It's not saving my settings. Hello? I'm turning you off, Automod. Okay, there you go. Yeah, for some reason, you have to do it twice in order for it to work. There you go. Okay, he's gone now. He will no longer cause pain for all of you, because I'm sure that he was causing pain. Yeah, Volve, good. I'm happy that you made it to a stream. It's always nice to have you on here. As you can see, we're here playing Pokemon Sun. Doing very well. Right, doing very well, yeah. We have the very worst evolution on our team, which is Umbreon. Or at least one of the worst evolutions. Like, I think my least favorite evolution anyway has to be Leafeon. I don't know base stat-wise, if Leafeon is worth it, but I just don't like Leafeon that much. Hano Beach is where you can find Starmie. Okay, I don't know why Automod was blocking Hano Beach. Your Hano Beach message, dude. That is what you're trying to send me, right? That's just very strange. This dude is a fighter. He's gonna sucker punch our- No, not the Pokemon move sucker punch, but he's gonna punch our Umbreon to death. And we wouldn't want that. Good morning! Morning for short! It's not even morning, dude. It's like 4:10. Yeah, I am so sorry. I don't know why Automod was probably just in a sour mood. Little does this man know that my Raichu is psychic. Because upon first glance, I would not have guessed it either. I mean, I think that honestly, I would have thought that Alolan Raichu is psychic. Not psychic, excuse me. I would have thought that Alolan Raichu was at least flying type. You know, even from its ears, it looks like it's got wings on its ears. Like, remember from Super Mario 64, had Mario had that wing cap? It kind of looks like that, the wings from the cap. And then, of course, he's floating, so... I don't know, I thought that electric and flying could have been a possible type combination for this guy. I am traumatized, yeah. I'll give it some time, dude. It'll take some time, but, you know, you'll get over it. Automod will be gone at least for this stream. Automod can still be useful. Like, I take back what I said about it being completely useless. It's just I think I had the restrictions on too tight, you know. So you're the one Gladion was talking about. You don't look anything special to me. You know, you shouldn't just say things like that to people that you first encounter. I help keep Team Skull together. I'm like a big sister to all these numbskulls. You have realized what idiots all these guys are, right? But don't you think some dummies are cute in their dumbness? You know what I mean? You picking on my cute, dumb brothers and sisters is really annoying me. Wow, suddenly thrust into a battle. I didn't expect a Team Skull battle all of a sudden. We did close the last stream with a Team Skull battle, right? Plumeria? Ooh, bad move, Plumeria. Blad move. Okay, Blad move is cool too. Wow, these guys, we're actually, I feel like we're over-leveled right now. 25. Really, Umbreon and Wimpod are the ones that need to do some catching up. I feel like everyone else is on at least 30. I could be wrong, not sure about that. But let's see. Landed this Pokemon again. No, it looks like Andre and Genus are still level 29s. They're 29ers. What is with this song in the background? Very edgy, Team Skull. Nice choice of soundtrack, Team Skull. May as well just go out on this guy. Oh no, 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 no. You don't want to poison me. That's not what you want to do. Oh, wow. No! Man, synchronize, come on. We were so close to getting him poisoned too. Apparently, Salandits can't be poisoned. Considering it's a poison type, am I right? Oh, yeah. Yeah. Andre the Kadabra, dude. Even in Oris, I named my Abra Andre, and then eventually it became Andre the Alakazam. I don't think I ever told him either that I named my Pokemon Andre. I'm sure he wouldn't mind, right? Thankfully, Umbreon's got one of these. Refresh. Nice. Why a normal type Z move? I think it was... Why do I have a... Mainly because I don't have a dark type Z move. Yeah, I don't have a dark type Z crystal. So I was like, you know what? I mean, it's got a normal type move, and if I want him to have some type of Z move, it has to be a normal type. So yeah, that's that very interesting story about that. Oh, it burns so badly. Yeah, I know. I know, not so impressive. I wish that I had a dark type Z crystal at this point in the game. What are the types of crystals that we have at this point? We've got fire, we've got... we have fighting because I remember giving it to Growlithe and I thought that that was very strange. Seeing a Growlithe carry out such a strong fighting type move like that. And then I think we have water, grass, and then normal. So, but mess with anyone else in Team Skull again, and I'll show you how serious I can get. She just kind of came out of nowhere, huh? I just wanted to go to the grand trial, and then he had to stop me like that. Okay, so this is the ruins of life. No, I didn't even know that there was a Musique crystal. That's crazy. Oh, okay. So do you mind if I ask a little bit about that? That Mew Z crystal, what's that all about? Lily got lost again, so I brought her here to you. Lily. She couldn't even find her way to the Tide Song Hotel on her own. She said she saw Team Skull and tried to avoid them, that's why she got lost. Now I've gotta go, the Masked Royal has a match and there's no way that I'm missing it. You mean your husband? She is so excited, that Masked Royal. What do you think he looks like under that- Oh, she doesn't know? I thought that she knew. Guess I'm just not remembering that right. Ah, so there's none yet. Okay. Whoa, so it is out, but you need Pokebank in order to get it. Well, I can't get it because I don't have Pokebank, but if you guys have not gotten that yet, you should. I'm very curious to hear about what that Mew Z crystal does. As you saw, I didn't come here myself so much as I was brought here with the professor's help. Oh, look at poor Raichu. Let me heal it for you, won't you? Yes, please. Unfair. Within these ruins waits the guardian deity of Akala Island. This is Tapu Lele's ruin. Tapu Koko and Tapu Lele. I know you tried to drag me along to the ruins of conflict on Mele Mele Island, too. Why are these ruins so important to you? What do the guardians mean to you? Yeah, of course he's not going to say anything. Yeah, just keep smiling like that. As cute as you are, you know. Just think what would have happened to you if ShdwJ hadn't been there back then. Pew! There you are. Okay, let's fight. Let's finish this grand trial, because we were supposed to do it in the last stream. Oh, haven't I seen you with Kukui? Oh yes, my name is Lily. I work as Professor Kukui's assistant. Yo, what's going on, Quack? Welcome to the stream. This whole time, don't worry. I knew that you were O'Lowry, man. Welcome to the stream. Glad to see you. How has life been? How has the YouTube channel been? How has the YouTube and Twitch life been? And this is ShdwJ. We already know each other, Lily. Don't worry. Oh, I guess not. I thought that we had done our introductions already. Okay. I guess we have to go through this then. Tapu Lele summoned me here to clean up the ruins. ShdwJ, thanks for getting to know the people and Pokemon of Alola. Yeah, well, my pleasure. We've met so many nice people here during our adventure, during our journey, you know? It's just been such a pleasure. Alright then. You've completed the trials of all three captains here on Akala Island. Now you face the grand trial of the Kahuna, me. Okay, so yeah, sure, it might be the hardest Pokemon of our lives. It would probably be good if we actually, Lily did heal us, right? I know that she was saying specifically the party in, the member in the front of our party, but I'm assuming that she healed all of our Pokemon, right? That only makes sense. You meet nice people, then Hao and Lily came along. Lily's pretty nice. Hao is nice. Very, very enthusiastic young boy. It's been pretty good, just hit 12k on YouTube, congratulations, man. I don't really stream on Twitch, just YouTube. How have things been for you? Things have been going well, you know, just chilling, streaming, just chilling with YouTube. And then, of course, school life, ministry life, but I definitely cannot complain. I'm gonna jump into this assuming that Lily did not just heal Butter, but that she healed all of our party members, you know what I mean? And my partners are all adorable, rugged little rock types. Alright, so by the way, if you guys love Smash, okay, Smash Bros, go ahead and check out Quack's channel, because, correct me if I'm wrong, Quack, but you do still do a lot of Smash, right? Mainly Smash? Island, Kahuna, Olivia. Whoa, that was very abrupt animation cut there. Oh, darn, no, this was not... Sending out this poor Butter here was not a good move, but we can at least nuzzle this guy. Set the stage for the Pokemon that I'm going to switch out afterwards, you know? Lily is nice but needy. Hao is enthusiastic, but too happy-go-lucky. Can't you just love them for how they are? Can't you just accept them for how they are? Why am I green? I didn't even know that you were green. Oh, you mean your username? Okay, just out of curiosity, let's see how much Psychic can do on this Nosepass. Like, I'm sure that your physical defense is... Bro, no. Full heal is foul play, bro. At least in my book. That's fair, right? Making using a full heal foul play if the person using it isn't me. I cannot accept them for how they are. I got you, dude. Very good. Yeah, that's really the only thing I play. I would like to expand content, but it's kind of difficult to find something else my viewers enjoy. Yeah, that's the thing. That's definitely a challenge, but still. Dude, 12k is no small thing. Again, congratulations to you reaching that, that 12k, that's crazy. You know? Normally, I wouldn't be using a- oh dang, that was a crit. Normally, I wouldn't be using Raichu against a nose pass. That would be the silliest thing to do, but it looks like Alolan Raichu has got this in the bag, so we may as well just finish this guy off with butter here. I am Nerd, welcome to the stream. How are you doing this fine evening? Come on, Olivia, is that all you got? Come on! Lycanroc. That name sounds familiar, but I don't think that I've encountered a Lycanroc before. So, to play it safe, Guinness probably isn't the best Pokemon to send out in this case, even though he is grass. Sturdy, for some reason, activates. For some reason or another. Thanks, so good to talk to you again, and so good to talk to you again too. Hey, by the way, Quack, like, I noticed that you've been pretty big into anime lately, so I'm just curious, what anime have you been watching lately, if any? I need to get back into anime, you know? Man, I feel like today I'm stuttering a little bit more than I normally do. Well, welcome back, Ugly Bob. I thought that your username would be the same as, this guy looks like a frickin' Looney Tunes character, dude. Lycanroc. Liken the design, man. Liken the design, Lycanroc. No? But anyway, enough of that. Oh boy, with the Z type. Okay, I'm pretty sure it's rock. So goodbye, Guinness. Continental Crush, wow, really? Goodbye, Guinness. Such an intimidating name for a move. Oh, stomp! I was flat pressed today. Well, Guinness, it's been good. Play it safe brings out a flying Pokemon. I know. It's just that I wanted to see how he would do because, you know, with grass type, you know, it's still flying and grass. So I was like, let's just try. And then we all saw how that turned out. Wasn't that fantastic? Alright, looks like Andre is going to have to play it now. This week I finished Hanasako Iroha, and before that I watched Clannad and Clannad After Story. Bro, I'm not familiar with the first anime, but Clannad and Clannad After Story are two of my favorite anime. They were really some of the only anime that really made me cry. Like, I'm not gonna say why it made me cry, lest you guys have not seen it yet. But for real, I love Clannad so much. This is the Midnight Lycanroc. You have sun, so it is different. Yeah. I wanted to see how it would do. Yeah, well, it did horrible. Ooh, nice! Very good. At least we can take this guy out now. Didn't expect Andre to have such an easy time with this Lycanroc. So apparently there are two different forms of Lycanroc here. I don't know if it's really design, or I'm pretty sure that typing also plays a role in those different forms. Yes, Clannad was spoken into the microphone. Please don't cry though. Nagisa. Or should I say Nagisa? I don't know how to pronounce it. Like, I like the original version, the Japanese pronunciation. Honestly, when I first heard someone's the English dub say Nagisa, I was like, oh, that's I don't know if I'm comfortable with that right now. Absolutely destroyed my emotions. It was so good, yeah. And still, well, I won't say anything about the ending. Like I said, I'll refrain from spoiling anything at all. Reflect, protect me, please! I like how in this game, reflect now is an oval, when before it was a rectangle. Just an observation there. Baldur, I just realized how creative this guy's name is. Baldur. Seriously did not expect Andre to be carrying us through this battle. You know, with his very weak defense, but Reflect definitely came in clutch. GG, Olivia. You know what? I don't think that I've been really giving much attention to Kadabra here. Poor Kadabra. Poor Andre. Wait, what did she say? I was just so hasty in a... No, I mean, like, I'm okay caring for you, Raichu, but I wanted to care for Andre. What the heck? Why are you out here? Is it the person who's in the front of the party? I thought that it was just the person that was last out in battle that would be tended and cared for. Like, Andre could have been the one receiving such a nice brush to the coat. But instead, all of a sudden, Butter is here. Yeah, welcome back, Ugly Bob. Switching from Twitch to YouTube is Ugly Bob. Oh man, he just loved that. Any good anime you would recommend? Quack has probably got you covered with some of the newer anime. Like, I haven't watched any of the newer anime. I really should. One anime that I've been meaning to watch is Sound Euphonium. I've been hearing a lot of positive things about that show, and it's by Kyoto Annie, so definitely want to give it a shot. So, Butter, you've had enough loving. Now it is time for Andre to receive some loving. Let's see. Right off the bat, have you seen... Let's see, I feel like a lot of the anime that I've watched, you've seen too, Volve. Alolan Raichu, cutest Pokemon, right? And I already loved normal Raichu, dude. I loved normal Raichu and taking care of him in Pokemon and me back in Gen 6. You need more of these beans. Take a red one. Let's see, anime recommendations. I'm drawing a blank. Of course, Dragon Ball Super. I mean, that's more or less a given, but for real. If you haven't watched Dragon Ball Super yet, Volve, you should definitely jump into that. They're starting the new arc. I think it's called the Universe Survival Arc or something like that. But yeah, dude, have you guys, for those of you guys that are Dragon Ball fans, did you see female Broly? Like, it's not really Broly, and Broly isn't canon. I didn't know that at first, honestly. I know that he wasn't in the manga, but I didn't know that he wasn't really considered canon by Toriyama just because he wasn't in the manga. Like, I thought that the anime OVAs or whatever were still canon. But yeah, dude, it looks crazy. It looks crazy. I really gotta start catching up on some Dragon Ball Super. I haven't watched personally, but the whole anime community praises JoJo's Bizarre Adventure. We're in the same boat, dude. Like, so many people have been saying so many great things about JoJo's Bizarre Adventure, but I haven't jumped into it myself. Twin Star Exorcist, and that's really good. Nice. Yeah, yeah. See? I told you Quack's got you covered with the anime recommendations, dude. Yeah, man, I gotta watch more Crunchy. Here, the Rock-type Z Crystal, the Rockium Z is yours. Well, that's very nice, but I'm pretty sure that we don't have a Rock-type Pokemon. Or even a Pokemon that knows Rock-type moves in the very least. But Grand Trial completed, that's a pretty big... This is a pretty big occasion for us here on the channel, in the chat, you know? The Rock-type Z power, you have to move like this to draw it out. Watch carefully, because the hit movement is crucial. Do you guys have to attach dance moves to it, to the attacks? Well, of course it's more fun that way. Oh, look at this, Lily is now, she's being tempted to become a Pokemon trainer just because of all this awesome stuff she's seen on our journey. The rock type. It's hard, sturdy, rugged, and physically strong. So nothing like me at all. I guess opposites really do attract. At least she's honest. What you want, Nebby? You look very pleased, don't you? By the way, Lily, this might be a weird question, but why even come to the Ruins of Life if you're not a trainer? Oh, because of Nebby. It's not originally from here, and I want to help it get inside, get back to itself. I don't know where I saw the word inside. But I don't have any idea how to do that. It seems fond of the ruins for some reason, so I keep visiting them and hoping that maybe I will find some clue to help it. You certainly don't see Pokemon like that every day. Tapu Lele may be called the guardian deity of our island, but it can also run wild at times. Regular Pokemon normally avoid the guardians at all costs, unless they are strong enough to face the Tapu themselves, that is. Get in the bag, exactly. Nebby, don't cause any more trouble. You just get in the bag right now, young Pokemon. Wait, that can't be right. I think your journey will hold many surprises, and I hope it holds many joys. I'll take you back to town, Lily. You're doing everything you can for your partner, even though you're not a trainer. I like that kind of person, so I can't help but give you a hand. See, Lily is so nice. Yes, just like what Sealskin was saying, she is very needy. Yes, I'll speak of the devil. The other person we were talking about earlier is Hao, and here he is, standing before us. Oh, hey ShdwJ. Guess what? This weird green guy from Aether told me to come to Hano Grand Resort once I finished up with my grand trial here in Akala. Crazy, right? Oh, the Aether Foundation? I'm not sure what he wants with you, ShdwJ, but why not go find out? If you don't want to keep him waiting, then Charizard should get you there in no time. The Hano Grand Resort lies just over the bridge near the Dimensional Research Lab. The Aether Foundation? I think I'll stay here. I'd like to see how Hao's battle goes too. Yeah, the members of the Aether Foundation were the ones chasing Lily at the very beginning of the game, huh? I don't know why they were so malicious looking in the beginning, cause like when we encountered them, they seemed very friendly. Lily must have done something pretty bad. Lily, what did you do? But I can still raise up Brionne and the rest of my team to do their best. Oh, Brionne. The starter that everyone so far has been saying that I should have gone with. And what's wrong with that? Who cares if you're Hala's grandson? Now show me what Hao can do. Yeah, he really is just ready to take on anything that life throws at him. Which is good! Which is good, that was not a criticism, as much as that sounded like a criticism. She murdered someone, duh. Well, I mean, I guess that would make sense why they were so upset. That's pretty bad, then. That's bad, Lily. Wait, can I go into the cave? I doubt that we can catch Tapu Lele yet, but I'm just gonna check to see for myself. No, it doesn't look- yeah, we need strength for this. We definitely cannot do this yet. Bye-bye, Tapu Lele. We will see you sometime soon, but just not today. Hey, sorry if I missed anything. My dog hopped on me and wouldn't move. No problem. That's adorable, though. I see that you're a dog person, huh? Any other dog people out there? Like, don't get me wrong, cats are cute too, but I'm allergic. And I just prefer dogs, honestly. I love dogs. And it's funny, because even though I love dogs, my dog does not love me for some reason. I don't know why, but she always feels threatened by me. Like, she doesn't want me petting her in any way. The word more or less is territorial, I guess. She's very territorial. And I wish that she would just understand that I love her so much. Even though she, yeah, can be a very bad dog. Her name is Sheena. She's a German Shepherd. So now that Stoutland is out of the way, we can actually cross this bridge. I want to get carried around in Pelipper's beak too. Take me somewhere. Be careful what you wish for, young ones. I would say be very careful with what you wish for. Alola is so interesting because it has all these different architectural styles thanks to so many people coming here from all over. Yeah, for real. That's one thing, you know? It's one thing that there are really so many islands in Alola, but that each of the cities really have such different architectural styles, you know? It's really interesting. Oh, nothing here. Looks like I went the wrong way. Oh, look at this little Pikachu just on vacation. Just enjoying life. You enjoy your little break. Although I don't know why you're the one lying down and it's not this dude. Master Chuster, this is your first vacation in 3 years. Please forget that you are a famous star. Oh, so this- oh wow. Dude, we're meeting a celebrity here, live, on the stream. Everyone, this is Master Chuster.
Pikachu!
Pika? Wait, Shoo Shoo. Are you sending me away? Wow, what a scumbag. Just, wow. It's like the stereotypical image of a celebrity, you know? Treating me like garbage. I'm gonna take a nap. I'm exhausted. Good luck with the rest of your stream. No problem, dude. You enjoy your nap, man. Thanks for stopping by. Always a pleasure. Is this the same Stoutland that was blocking the way? Yeah, this is the same dude. They're still looking for treasure and rocks or whatever. I'm a real man of the season. I consider it my duty to keep the beach safe. So here's my warning to you. The only people you'll find swimming in the water here are Pokemon trainers. Be careful out there. We will, we will. We do have, yeah, we do have surf now. So if we wanted to, we could take on those trainers. But we gotta go to the hotel first. Wow, I have not seen such generosity in this game where they just give me a soda pop just like that. What, would you rather have had the soda pop that I already started drinking? Was my character giving her a strange look? If anything, I thought that he would be grateful. The only reason I can luxuriate like this now is thanks to the work I do here on this beach. If you're interested in some part-time work, why don't you try chucking some puke? Glistening sweat, slippery goo, the perfect tune that keeps Hano Beach going. I really don't know how to pronounce that, and oops! I didn't mean to deny your request, whatever it was. Like, I wasn't even paying- won't you become a Pyukumuku. There you go, Pyukumuku, I'm pretty sure that's right. Free soda, right? It's a pretty good evening so far. I'm one of the staff members responsible for keeping Hano Beach spotless for our guests. But Pyukumuku sometimes wriggle up on our beach from the sea. I don't know why they do it, but we can't just leave them here. They shrivel up on land, and that's not all. Our guests get grossed out seeing them, and sometimes even get hurt stepping on them. Okay, what kind of Pokemon are we talking about right now? So we end up with no choice but to chuck those poor Pyukumuku back into the sea. I'll explain the job to you. It's pretty easy. Step 1, catch Pyukumuku. Step 2, throw the Pyukumuku back into the sea. I don't have that many Pokeballs, dude, so I don't really know if I'm the one that you should be relying on right now. I am too busy. We'll have to come back and do this later. This little mini-game. I don't know what we're going to earn from it, but... Pyukumuku. Okay, so that's how you pronounce it. Whoa, that's a... Pyukumuku, isn't it? Pretty sure it's Pyukumuku. But whatever, I'm gonna see what this Pyukumuku is for myself. Why are you guys That's not a Pyukumuku. Sandygast? Whoa, this is a brand new Pokemon to me. Like many of the Pokemon from this region, I've at least seen on Twitter. But not this one. I'm very new. This guy is very new to me. Oh darn. Oh darn, she didn't heal us after our little battle. The grand child. What's her name? Olivia. Olivia didn't heal us. You don't need Pokeballs for that. But he was saying that you catch them with a... what's it called? You catch them, right? So I assume that you would use Pokeballs. I don't know, maybe I'm going to have to speak to him again just to confirm. Confirm use Pokeballs or nah? Oh, you know what I will confirm? I'm going to confirm that I'm going to stop by the Pokemon Center. Our Pokemon are in pretty desperate need of healing. Is there even a Pokemon Center here? Probably in the resort, huh? This is where we needed to go anyway. Nah? Okay, I guess I'll speak to him later then. Let's help him out then. If he doesn't need Pokeballs, then I guess that we can offer our services to him. So you've come at last. Ah, but forgive me, I have yet to introduce myself. You may call me Faba. I told you before that I would show you someplace astounding, right? Well, that wondrous place is Aether Paradise. Let me tell you about Aether Paradise. Just as the name suggests, Aether Paradise is a veritable paradise for Pokemon that floats far out in the sea surrounding Alola. What's going on, Tohawo? Welcome back to the stream, with the silly little emoji there. Hope that you've been doing well. It is an artificial island made entirely by human technology for the protecting of Pokemon. Of course, I'm an adult who keeps his promises, so I will prove to you that all I've told you is the absolute truth with a tour of Aether Paradise. You will come, won't you? Yeah, sure, why not? I just wanted to heal my Pokemon, but I mean, having a tour of this Aether Paradise, or dang, you guys are fast. Just asking, are you looking at other games to stream? Yeah, dude. Actually, before you came, we were streaming Tales of Symphonia. Remember that game that we were let's playing on the YouTube channel? But then it kind of just stopped. Yeah, we're redoing it, and this time in stream form. Other than that, we're also doing Majora's Mask 3D and then Animal Crossing New Leaf. So yeah. The channel now is what they call a variety streaming channel, in the sense that we'll no longer stick with just one game. We'll be playing, a good number of different games, so. Now that I've got any, not today mind you, this is the last game that we'll stream, but you guys get what I'm saying. Not that I've got any, I've never even gotten married. Listen up, you two. Your greatest opponent is always yourselves, your greatest allies, the Pokemon beside you. Thanks! Are you coming too, Professor? Still got your same team or you changed something? Well, some of the Pokemon did evolve. Other than that, I don't really, no, they really didn't change. I've got my own business to attend to. You go see all the amazing tech that Aether's developing and tell me about it later, yeah? That's right, I'll see you on the next island. Ualualu Island, yeah? Then let's meet up at Mali Garden. Yup, it's goodbye, Akala Island. Man, this game has just been throwing so many unique names at me, and I have just been butchering all of them. Then let us enjoy an adventure upon the grand vessel that will take us across the high seas. Animal Crossing is the best, says Ugly Gamer. Dude, I love Animal Crossing. I was so excited to be starting Animal Crossing New Leaf. Again, I restarted my town all over. Sadly, Tom Nook didn't offer to appraise my town and give me money for, you know, getting rid of my town and starting afresh, but it's okay. I'm just happy that we're playing Animal Crossing on the channel. Can you believe a big hunk of iron like Aether Paradise can float in the sea? And it's all because of the Pokemon holding it up. Did you know that, Shadow Jay? Well, did ya? Knew I could count on you to react. Oh, I can't wait to actually see inside Aether Paradise for myself. Yep. My character just looks so intrigued just now. Wow, it really is just far out there. Aether Paradise. Okay, I'm guessing that this is where Lily actually came from. I don't know, just a guess. And of course, when I said came from, I mean where she was at the very beginning of the game. I could be very wrong, but we'll see. Oh, and by the way, it looks like we won't be able to do that little game where we help out that dude on the beach. He'll have to wait. What Pokemon hold it up? I have no idea, honestly. Here we are, you two. This is Aether Paradise. Oh, Sudowoodo! Oh, look at him! Look at Sudowoodo! Look at his dance moves! Yeah! Yeah! Aether Paradise is a facility created for the conservation of Pokemon. It has been outfitted with all of the latest technology for this purpose. Downstairs, our teams work on developing new Pokeballs and more. Ooh! If you're working on Master Balls as well, some classic Pokeballs, do you mind if I maybe had a peek at one of those Master Balls? You can trust me. Though you will not be able to use any of our Pokeballs within Aether Paradise. A jamming signal is broadcast throughout the facility to prevent them from functioning. Hmm. Interesting. Millions of Magikarp? Really now? Like you would have thought that maybe millions of Gyarados? Yeah, sure, but I mean, having millions of Magikarp serve as the foundation for such a giant floating island upon which many technologies are developed? That's pretty good too. Yes, excuse you. Hey, this is that girl. What's her name? Isn't her name Wick or something? I remember Etika recently made a video with a Smash modding video, and apparently someone imported the model of this character from this game into Smash Bros. It's pretty crazy. How else will anyone know how important I am? Someone's gotta deflate that big head of yours. Now, I must go speak with the president about our conservation efforts on Akala. Show these children around, and then take them to meet the president as well. She's Velma, okay, so not Wick. I don't know where I got Wick from. Yeah, this is the same character that, yeah, Wick, see? Oh, Velma from Scooby-Doo? Oh, you got me. I didn't even realize that you were talking about that Velma. Dang it. My name is Wick. Wait, you know who we are? How'd you know that? Okay, yeah, now I got that she's Wick. One of our employees told me about your meeting on Akala Island. And of course, I heard how you helped protect the Pokemon there too, young Mr. Howe. Thank you very much. Let me show you around. The main entrance is up above us. What are we really going to find here? So what are we going to find that's of use to us here in the Aether Foundation? Well, items that we can't steal anyway. Wait, there's that ape Pokemon that I think that we could find in the forest, right? Where the grass trial was. You can have your Pokemon taken care of at the reception desk there if they need it. Yeah, that's really all I wanted when I was going into the hotel, and then all of a sudden we found ourselves here at the Aether Paradise. Why do Pikachu and Rockruff have to be so adorable? You and Howe are both trial goers, aren't you? Are you hoping to become champions? I suppose. You must be around 11 then. Oh wow, our character's only 11? I don't know, I imagine him to be just a little bit older than that, but I mean, most Pokemon protagonists are around that age, so this shouldn't really have been a surprise to me. Yeah, I took the first chance I had to join in the Island Challenge once I turned 11. Cause someday, I really want to be able to beat my Gramps, but he's way too strong. Yeah, for right now, dude, but eventually, if you keep working at it, if you keep training, you will get there, my child. How lovely for you. I suppose all children must yearn to take a journey of their own choosing when they get to be about your age. Though you're hardly just children anymore, trainers are like parents to their Pokemon. ShdwJ, how? Would you like to see the conversation, or the conservation area? Upstairs? We'll zip right up. This place is huge, but I wanted to heal my Pokemon though. Oh yeah, for sure, this is the exact same area that we found Lily in at the beginning of the game. For this reason, the use of Pokeballs is strictly forbidden within the conservation area. Wow! We keep Pokemon that have been targeted by Team Skull here, and we also try to support Pokemon that need a little extra protection. Like Corsola, for example, they are quite terribly overhunted by a Pokemon called Toxapex. I hope you don't mind if I read a passage from my Pokedex. There's Corsola! And there's Starmie. Sadly, we cannot actually use Pokeballs in here, so you're just going to have to wait before you can join our team, Starmie. Sadly. Toxapex crawls along the ocean floor on its 12 legs. It leaves a trail of Corsola bits scattered in its wake. Oh boy. Yeah, my Gramps is always saying that nature's got its cruel side, sure as it gives us blessings. Yikes, right? Right, Ugly Bub? Rip Corsola. Yeah, that poor Pokemon. But then again, like what I was saying, man, there can be some pretty cruel Pokemon out there. But then again, that's just how the cycle of life works. Minus the thing about Drifloon, like what I was saying earlier. It's not necessary for Drifloon to take away children to oblivion in order to survive. I don't understand why it's got to do that. Nature does have its own balance, of course. It can be difficult to judge just how much we humans should try to affect that, can it? That's pretty amazing! The Aether Foundation seems awesome! But why'd you bother setting up a branch in a place like Alola? I couldn't say. It's hard to know for sure what our president is thinking sometimes. And who is your president? If you'd like to meet President Lusamine. I'm pretty sure it's Lusamine. She should be here in the conservation area now. You look too generic to be a president. Where could you be? Oh man, I feel like Lily right now, at the very beginning of the game. Like I'm telling you, this must be the place where she was. Regional variants. It can all seem a bit complicated, but think about it like this. If you visit a tropical region, you get a tan, right? Isn't it something like that? I guess. I'm guessing that... I mean, even before we came here, it seemed like the Aether Foundation was experimenting on Nebby or something, and then I guess Lily wanted to save Nebby? I don't know. That's what I'm guessing happened, but maybe it's a lot more complicated than that, because that seems a little bit too obvious. My sweet Pokemon, I promise I'll keep you safe. I'll protect you with all of my love. Come, my children. Receive your embrace. She looks like Cynthia with, like, a lot more hair. Almost. Wait, she's just a child? Or does she just look like a child? Because she looks very young to me. Welcome to the Aether Paradise, the Aether Foundation's own private island. I am the president of the Foundation, but please, just call me Lusamine. I'm so glad that we got to meet. I'm glad there are people like you who travel the islands to learn more about Pokemon. Oh no, she's not a child. She looks pretty tall. She's 43. Oh, dang. I guess she just has a baby face then. But then again, she is an anime character, so you know how it is. But there are also those unfortunate people who harm Pokemon for their own selfish reasons or even for profit. And that is why I am here. I will be like a mother to all of those poor Pokemon and shower them with my love. Come, my children. Even Pokemon from distant worlds far from the Alola region are worthy of my love. Wow, Miss Lusamine. I don't know how you do all this. You're, like, not even that much older than us. Oh, you sweet boy. See, even Hao is confused about her age. I'm over 40. You are? I'm 43, punk. Wait, what? Oh, you. The right style does wonders, you know. And Hao, your style is a bit wanting, hmm? I'll have to take you out sometime and help you pick a smashing outfit. Like what you wear? I don't think anyone else could pull off that kind of look except maybe Lily. No, how? Shh, we don't mention Lily here. We're not gonna mention Lily here. Oh, don't you Oh, wait a second. Is this Lily's mother? Trust me, children. Trust me, children would all be much happier if they'd only listen to the adults around them. Yeah, I feel like this is Lily's mother. Like, doesn't Lily have green eyes too? Like, the blonde hair, obviously, but doesn't Lily have green eyes too? That tremor. Something happened on the lower floors? Sounds like there was an experiment that went haywire. Or not. Or instead, it looks like we could have a giant wormhole leading to another dimension with this jellyfish Pokemon coming out. That's a lot more interesting than a science experiment gone wrong. What is this? Wait, do you want me to catch you, dude? Because I don't know if I have many Pokeballs left, honestly. She kind of looks like Lily in Pokemon form. Yo, not gonna lie, that thing looks pretty nasty. You poor creature. Should we just... guess we'll just approach it. Pokeballs won't work. Yeah, that's right. Durr! Sorry. I completely forgot. So it looks like we're just going to have to knock this dude out. Not even a name. Oh, what? Are you serious? Was not expecting a totem Pokemon. That's basically what this is. Okay, let's see what we got. It has the weirdest typing. Really now? Okay, so it looks like thunder moves or electric moves are, they're just effective against it, I guess. How about psychic? Psychic good? Well, I mean, that was pretty easy, honestly. Not that I'm complaining, you know, finishing the battle pretty quick is always nice. Didn't really get to see it perform many moves, though. Did we just kill a Pokemon that could be- oh. What's going on? Don't die, we need to research you! So it's true, I still need that Pokemon. I need to get it back. What? Miss Lusamine, did you say something? So the only thing that- oh, dang. I don't like that look in your eyes. The creature we just saw was undoubtedly an Ultra Beast. An unknown being from another dimension that suddenly appears from the Ultra Wormhole. It looks like it was suffering. Like it pained it to be in this strange place. I can't bear to see that happen. I will save it. I will love it. Oh man. I did not expect to see a tsundere here on the stream. She's like a Pokemon tsundere. Have you guys seen the Pokemon version of Future Diary? Because this is what it's about to become. Yes, don't die. Sorry, I could have worded that better. I could have worded that better. These two are still in the middle of their island challenge, aren't they? Please deliver them to their next island. Oh, at once, ma'am. I will go to check that none of our poor resident Pokemon came to any harm. And I need to speak with Mr. Faba about exactly what happened downstairs. And of course, I will have to start preparing the foundation for our newest and perhaps greatest duty yet. The protection of the Ultra Beasts. I'll see the two of you to Ula Ula Island then. Ula Ula! At Ula Ula, we're gonna be making some Mula Mula. Bye-bye, Lusamine. Or should I say Lily's mother? Dun dun dun! I'm really not sure. Don't worry, guys. If you guys haven't played it yet, it's not a spoiler. Because I really have no idea. I'm just assuming that that's Lily's mother. She looks like Lily, come on. I never thought I'd actually get to see the Ultra Wormhole in my life. We've got to tell Professor Burnett about this the next time we see her. I don't know if what happened should be rightly described as an accident, but I think it's probably best if you do so. Anyway, I was very glad to get to meet you both. Please take this to remember your visit. Some Malisadus for Hal. Oh, he'd love that, wouldn't he? Yes, big Malisadus! Isn't it crazy how Malisadus taste? Yes, I know what you mean. See, even Wick isn't entertained with this child anymore. And for Yusha, wow! Okay, Hal, you can keep those Malisadus. Don't even bother sharing them. I have a pretty nice gift of my own. I mean, look. Kadabra really was going to learn Psychic anyway by himself, but still, that's... TM Psychic is pretty great. How does she know that he likes Malisadus? Because Wick is actually Hal's mother. Dun dun dun! We will, thanks Miss Wick. But yeah, with Psychic. Oh, my heart's still kind of racing, you know? man, this guy is just always on the move. Oh yeah, well I guess, yeah, with the Ultra Beast, with how the Ultra... Dude, you're embarrassing me. We're in a public place, could you not be so loud, bro? Shh. We're gonna need all the energy we can get. Time to dig in. Speaking of, I had a pretty heavy lunch and I'm still hungry after like... Oh, it's almost been 4 hours actually, that's crazy. No, I said you can keep the Malisada, dude, as long as you let me keep the TM. Shoot, I already ate the whole thing. Dang it. Now I gotta wait till we get to the next town before I can get another Malisada. So, Ultra Beasts. Very mysterious. I'm really lost. I don't know what's going on with that. Ugly Bob says, come on, how? Yeah, come on, man. We were in a public place. Like, I know that it's good to be excited about things, but you know, you gotta maintain that decency in public, you know? Hello, Pelipers. This place almost looks like that other town that we were in. The town near the Grand Trial. I completely forgot the name already. But that's not important. Alright, Terra Firma underfoot again. So how was Nihiligo? I don't know. Cause I don't know who that is. Welcome to China, more culture than you'll ever get. Yeah, let's see. Yeah, I'm really getting an Asian vibe from this place. Ula Ula Island is like another totally different place than Mele Mele or Akala, huh? I've got an idea, Shadow Jing. Dude, could you wait? Okay, let's humor him. I think that it wouldn't be good to, you know, discourage this young child, even though we are practically the same age. You know, we don't want to discourage him from that excitement that he's got, you know, it's nothing wrong with having that as long as you just stop embarrassing me in public. How? Yes, I don't know. What was that? The name that you just said? Nihilego. Nihiligo. Man. Whoa, wait a second, this is foul play. How, don't you know that you're not allowed to do this? Believe me, it's tournament official rules where they say that you're not allowed to have the same Pokemon out. So, you can go ahead and put your little Raichu away, huh? Okay, well anyway, I'm going to show you who the better Raichu is. You probably have Nuzzle too, huh? I don't remember what level we got Nuzzle at, but yeah, that's one of the problems with our team right now. We don't really have many Pokemon that would do well against Electric, but thankfully, Alolan Raichu is Psychic, so we can at least try to use Lucina in this battle. You know, come on, she needs the levels, you know? She needs the levels. I'll know what it is, I imagine, but not the fastest Raichu. Yeah, not the fastest Raichu. Yeah, because his has quick attack. I don't think mine has quick attack. Yeah, no problem, Ugly Bob. Thanks for stopping by. Hope you have a good rest of your evening. Okay, now that's a move that I want. Electro Ball. How did you get Electro Ball, son? Now, Brion. I was going to switch out to Butter, but I think that we should give Guinness some love, you know. He hasn't seen much action lately, aside from when he died from Lycanroc. Poor Guinness. He didn't stand a chance. Ooh, bringing in the Waterium Z, I guess. Aw, she's so cute too. Hydro Vortex? Come on, that's not gonna be enough. That's not gonna be enough, right? Right? Oh, dang. That looks brutal. Nah, but it still wasn't enough. Yeah, it's... Isn't Bryon your preferred starter in this case? I feel like, Guinness here is a... No, dude! Oh, dang. Oh, man. I wanted a Flareon. I already have an Arcanine, though, so it wouldn't have worked out. I wanted a Vaporeon. That's what I wanted from my evolution, my Eeveelution. Sadly, I didn't know that we were approaching a town that sold the evolution stones, but, you know, Umbreon, Lucina, you're still cool. You're still good in my book. I just really wanted a water type. Dang it. And now look at us. We don't even have anything that can take on this Flareon. Yeah, we're going to need to do some team adjustments later on. I love Bryon. Last Eeveelution has coverage over the other starters. Yeah, I mean, really, for most water types, I feel like that's the case. And, you know, at least what people told me before is- Ooh, dang. Dang, dang, dang. Yeah, well, goodbye. Goodbye, Andre. Hands down, best Gen 7 starter. I like Litten only because of his, like... His name was adorable. Litten. Especially the way that people use Litten now. It's like, you couldn't help but expect people to go, oh man, Litten? That's pretty lit! With the on fleek emoji or whatever you want to call it. Well, Andre did not last long out there. Should have expected that, though, with his very low defense. I was honestly thinking that he would use, like, more special attacks, but clearly I was wrong there. I'll nuzzle you! Don't make me nuzzle you! Oh man, that did a lot. Here's hoping that Flareon will be paralyzed. Yes, he's paralyzed. Tried to do quick attack, huh? Nice try, Flareon. That's not happening today. Ooh, two times in a row, okay. I'm happy. I'm a happy man right now. Bye-bye, Flareon. Litten is second. The Pokemon in Alola... in Alola aren't fast, but they are bulky and harder hitters. Rowlet is so frail, yeah. Like, I know that the last time he died was... That was still my fault, but still, yeah. I noticed that, Guinness isn't exactly, yeah, he is pretty frail. Okay, but anyway, Guinness, don't... forget what I was saying about you just now. You're not frail! You're strong, you've got this. He's actually really frail. I'm excited to see his last form, though. I'm pretty sure that I stumbled upon it somewhere on Twitter or something, but I don't remember what it looks like, so I'm excited to see what it is. Well, that was a Z-move and twice the damage. I guess that's true. But still. Rah, I had my breath held that whole battle. You'd be dead by now if you really did. You liar. Ah, that battle took my breath away. I can't breathe, or I can't breathe the fresh air that way. We're supposed to meet up with the professor, right? Where was it? Mali Garden? He's frail. He's a glass. Not cannon. Pistol. Glass pistol. Yes. Why'd he want us to go to a garden? Guess we'll, find out when we get there, right? Oh, wait, what do you gotta say? You've made it to Ula Island now, big boy. This means a whole new island Pokedex. It's all up to you what new Pokemon you'll uncover here, Shadow J. Nice, nice. Alright, guys. I'm actually going to, wait. I'm actually going to go ahead and end the stream. for tonight, because I'm actually starting to feel a little bit tired, you know. But man, I had a great time today. I had a great time playing Tales and Phony. I had a great time playing Pokemon. So thank you guys for stopping by and, you know, just sticking around in the chat, you know. Just sometimes chatting, sometimes lurking here and there. It was fun. Yeah, we'll see the garden during our next Pokemon stream. But anyway, thank you guys for tuning in. I will see you guys on the very next stream. Oh, and by the way, I guess I'll just go ahead and do a little bit of a plug. I uploaded our... Yo, thank you very much for the follow, Sealskin. Wait a second. Wait, you haven't followed yet? Really? And you would still stumble upon the stream? Well, anyway, thank you very much for the follow. If I may, just a little bit of a plug. I uploaded the very first highlight video for our Pokemon series here on Twitch onto YouTube. So with the highlight videos, I tend to do a little bit of editing, you know. So in case you were wanting to watch a 4-minute long video, short video, you know, be sure to check out the YouTube channel, because we'll be uploading more highlight videos there. You know, I love streaming on Twitch, but I don't know what I would do if I didn't sit down and edit videos as well, you know what I mean? But anyway, thank you guys for stopping by. I will see you guys on Wednesday, where we will be playing some more games. We'll be doing some more streaming. Alright guys, you have a great evening. I will see you guys then.